Hello friends, this is Vishal Sharma and welcome to our Beats YouTube channel. So today's topic is biotechnology. So we'll talk about all the recent developments and the future prospects of this emerging field. Before starting this particular lecture, I may request you to please follow our Beats YouTube channel. We are also on Facebook and Instagram. You can like and share our page. So let's start with this particular topic of biotechnology. So friends, you must have seen this particular picture right from your school days, and it's named as Dolly Sheep. It was the first genetically cloned animal that the scientists have produced by artificial method. So aap andaza laga sakte hain ki biotechnology ki aisi field jo hai, it can also create the animals through artificial methods. So we'll talk about this particular subject. If we talk about the biotechnology ka definition, it's a technology which utilizes the living organisms, the biological systems, or their products and their parts to develop or create different products that we can use in our day-to-day life. The biotech industry, it comprises more than 2,700 biotech startups at the moment in our country, and which comprises of 2,500 biotech companies in the country of India. India at present is amongst the 12 biotech destinations in the world and ranks second in Asia after China. And jo hamari biotech industry hai, in the near future, it is expected to significantly grow in terms of health, medical, and the biofuel industries. India at present is also the third largest producer of recombinant hepatitis B vaccine, and it's the second largest producer of BT cotton, which is a genetically modified crop. Agar hum market size ka baat kare, to Indian biotechnology jo hai, it's amounted to $63 billion in 2019, and it's forecasted to reach about $102 billion by 2025 with a growth rate of 10.9%. Or 2025 तक ये भी अनुमान लगाया जा रहा है, the contribution of Indian biotechnology, it will reach to near to 20% from today's 3%. तो बहुत सारे सेक्टर्स हैं बायोटेक्नोलॉजी में जिसमें कि बायोफार्मास्यूटिकल अकेले ही 60% का हिस्सेदारी वो रखता है और contributes a lot in the development of the medical industry. So it is followed by the bioagriculture and bioservices industries, which are also gaining very research motivated impetus in the country. If we talk about the various investments and developments, government of India ne bahut sare initiative liye hain taki is industry ko aur zyada ek high level pe le jaye, jiski wajah se hum pure ek duniya mein ek example set kare, so as ki wo hamare products use kar sake. So in that context, at present India allows 100% FDI, that is foreign direct investment, where in the foreign companies, they can also invest with 100% FDI in the pharmaceutical industry and other manufacturing medical devices. Bharat Biotech, in the recent times, it has planned to produce 10 types of vaccine, including malaria and COVID-19 vaccine, with a total investment of more than 300 crores at its upcoming unit in Bhubaneswar, Odisha. Government of India, बहुत सारे initiatives Government of India ने लिए हैं जिसमें कि Department of Biotechnology, Department of Science and Technology बहुत अच्छे से काम कर रहे हैं in motivating the research development in our country. So BIRAC is one such project which has been initiated by the Department of Biotechnology, Government of India, and it is aimed to strengthen and empower the emerging biotechnology enterprises and the startups to take strategic research and development and innovation in our country. In October 2020, Dr. Reddy's Laboratories Limited, they announced a partnership with BIRAC, Government of India, for advisory support on clinical trials of Sputnik 2 vaccine, which is a COVID vaccine in India. बहुत सारे और initiatives Government of India के द्वारा लिए गए हैं. इनमें से एक है National Biopharma Mission, which is Innovative India Mission 2017. It's a DBT program which is worth $250 million, and it aims to bring together all the industry and academia in order to promote entrepreneurship and indigenous manufacturing in biopharma industry. Moreover, jo hamare clinical trials hain usko badhava dene ke liye, Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has introduced new drugs and clinical trial rules from 2019, which has changed the regulatory landscape to approve the new drugs and conducting the clinical trials in our country. एक और इनिशिएटिव गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया द्वारा लिया गया टू प्रमोट हाई लेवल रिसर्च इन द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द कंट्री विच इंक्लूड्स बायोटेक पार्क्स. These are the biotech parks basically are the incubators which are established all over the country by the Department of Biotechnology under the Ministry of Science and Technology to translate research into products and services by providing necessary infrastructural support. No need to tell that at present India leading the way and leading all the countries in developing the COVID vaccines, and we have developed indigenously produced vaccines like Covaxin and Covishield, which have been developed by Serum Institute of India, Pune, and Bharat Biotech Company. So, Indian Immunologicals, it operates the world's second largest plant for veterinary vaccines also, and it also the world's largest manufacturer of the vaccine against foot and mouth diseases. So, hum baat karte hain ki India ek biotech hub kyun banta ja raha hai aur kyun banna chahiye? Because there are many landscape remarkable landscape and remarkable achievements that India have done in the past, and also has paved way for the recent developments in the this particular field. So we have excellent network of research laboratories, we have rich biodiversity, there is well developed base of industries, extensive clinical trials are being done, and we have a trained manpower, which is a major boost to our particular field of biotechnology. There are Indian players and Indian startups which have, you know, remarkably improved, and they have gained success in our country and abroad also. That includes Dr. Reddy's, Biocons, Nicholas, Shanta Biotech, and Serum Institute of India Limited. Moreover, many multinational companies, they have also scripted success in India with the companies like Bio-Rad, Millipore, Roche, and many other biotech and pharmaceutical industries. They are gaining success in India and investing in India. अगर हम अपनी बायोटेक्नोलॉजी को कंपेयर करें विद द बायोटेक्नोलॉजिकल डेवलपमेंट्स विद द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, तो इसराइल एट प्रेजेंट इट स्पेंड्स मोर देन 4% ऑफ इट्स जीडीपी इन रिसर्च ओनली, एंड इट फॉलोज द कंट्रीज लाइक साउथ कोरिया एंड चाइना. अगर हम इंडिया की बात करें, अनफॉर्चुनेटली इंडिया में अभी इतना इन्वेस्टमेंट रिसर्च के ऊपर नहीं है, एंड वी आर होपिंग दैट इन द नियर फ्यूचर द बिकॉज the research grants are also provided on a large scale so as to grow this particular field of biotechnology. Framework ki agar baat karein, so there are three major frameworks that outlines the broad categories which can be encompassed in the dimensions that provide the robust picture about this particular field, which includes enablers, facilitators, and the performance measures. So agar enablers ki baat karein, that includes the human capital, the investment in research and development, and the strength of legal institutions. If you talk about the facilitators, that includes the industry and academia collaboration. And if you talk about the performance measure, it evaluates the output indicators of the biotechnological industry, which includes the clinical trials, what are the research outputs and biotechnological outputs. One more promising field of this biotechnology is the creation or the production of biofuels. So as we know, we are always dependent, or we have been dependent, on the fossil fuels for meeting the energy demands, but their reserves are limited, and they are also creating a greenhouse effect and global warming. So we are under process of developing a green technology which can in near future can replace those fossil fuels. One such green technology is the development of the biofuels. So at present India mein बायोफ्यूल्स के ऊपर बहुत सारा रिसर्च हो रहा है, बट हम एक टेक्नोलॉजी वाले लेवल तक अभी नहीं पहुंच पाए हैं कि हम उस बायोफ्यूल को एक कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव मेथड से हम उसको एक इंडस्ट्रियल स्केल पे ले जाएं और एट लास्ट उसको हम अपने पंप्स पे, जो हमारे ऑयल पंप्स हैं, उन तक पहुंचा पाएं. सो बहुत सारे अभी उसमें हमें डेवलपमेंट करना ज़रूरी है. हमें लेसन्स लेने चाहिए फ्रॉम द कंट्रीज लाइक ब्राज़ील, फ्रॉम अर्जेंटीना, फ्रॉम यूएसए, जो कि 20-80% तक अपने इथेनॉल को ब्लेंड कर रहे हैं विद पेट्रोल और डीजल. सो हमारे पास एट प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने एक इनिशिएटिव लिया था. दे हैव सेड दैट वी विल बी ब्लेंडिंग 5% ऑफ बायोडीजल बाय 2030 एंड 20% ऑफ पेट्रोल ऑफ इथेनॉल विद द पेट्रोल बाय 2030. बट ये तभी पॉसिबल है जब हमारा रिसर्च इस तरीके से हो कि उसको हम इंडस्ट्रियल लेवल पे भी ले जाएं. बात करें अगर इंडियन बायोटेक्नोलॉजी अभी एट प्रेजेंट कहां पे लैक कर रही है, सो अकॉर्डिंगली यूनिवर्सिटीज में जो रिसर्च होता है और जो रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट्स में हमारा रिसर्च है दैट इज नॉट इन कोलैबोरेशन विद द इंडस्ट्रीज. सो इंडस्ट्री अकेडमिया रिसर्च इंडस्ट्री अकेडमिया कोलैबोरेशन होना बहुत ज़रूरी है. सो व्हाट इज़ द रीज़न व्हाई दीज इंडस्ट्री एंड रिसर्च ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस दे आर नॉट कोलैबोरेटिंग सो मच इन आवर कंट्री एट द मोमेंट. द लीडिंग रीज़न फॉर दिस गैप इज द नॉलेज ट्रांसफर and a lack of clarity on the ownership of intellectual property rights upon the completion of the research. And this makes the industry hesitant to collaborate with the universities for the research purposes. So I think ye jo ek barrier hai isko hame remove karna chahiye so that future mein industries or research organizations aapas mein milke collaborate karke ek platform taiyar kare jiski wajah se hamare jo products hain chahe wo biofuel ho chahe wo medicines ho chahe bioagricultural development ho और हमारे फार्मर्स हमारे मेडिकल इंडस्ट्री और ऑन द होल हमारे कंट्रीमैन को इसका फायदा मिल सके. व्हाट आर द फ्यूचर प्रोस्पेक्ट्स व्हाट इज द रोड अहेड. सो अगर हम बात करें एट प्रेजेंट इंडिया में एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप बायोटेक्नोलॉजी के फील्ड में बहुत ज़्यादा हो रहा है. सो हमें चाहिए कि उन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स को उन स्टार्टअप्स को प्रमोट किया जाए. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया नो डाउट इट इज़ प्रमोटिंग दोज स्टार्टअप्स विद द इनिशिएटिव्स लाइक मेक इन इंडिया स्टार्टअप इंडिया. So we have to see that those startups they are taken over on a large scale so as to develop them and also develop our country. तो अगर future biotechnology की बात करें so nanomedicine is one such emerging field of this biotechnology. It may use nanorobots machines and the nanorobots which can conduct a precise medical treatment microsurgeries and deliver the drugs. Synthetic biology and metabolic engineering is also one of the promising subjects which is related to biotechnology. Artificial intelligence, जो हम इतना आज के time में artificial intelligence का बहुत ज़्यादा जोर है. So biotechnology में भी artificial intelligence को हम introduce कर सकते हैं, कर भी रहे हैं और हो सकता है आगे आने वाले future में this artificial intelligence will be a boom to our biotechnology industry. If we talk about the 3D printing also, so it uses the biolink material to create tissues like structures layer by layer and these tissues they are then used to promote research and regenerative medicine. It also uses 3D printed tissues and organs for surgical planning. So all in all agar hum is biotechnology ki field ka baat kare dosto to it has got immense power immense potential in the near future in countries like ours. So baat sirf yahi hai ki hame government ke jo initiatives hain unko samajhna hoga और रिसर्च एकेडमी और इंडस्ट्री को कोलैबोरेट होके इन सबको साथ में मिलके हमारी बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इंडस्ट्री को आगे ले जाना पड़ेगा. और आई एम वेरी मच होपफुल दैट इन द नियर फ्यूचर वी आर गोइंग टू बी द लीडर्स एंड बॉस एंड लीड ऑल द नेशंस ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. सो आई विल थैंक यू फॉर लिसनिंग टू दिस लेक्चर. सो विल कम अप विद अ न्यू लेक्चर इन द नियर फ्यूचर. टिल देन गुड बाय एंड टेक केयर ऑफ योर हेल्थ. बाय बाय.
द बीट्स फॉर यू नॉर्थ अमेरिका में बसने वाले भारतीयों का एक ऐसा इनिशिएटिव जिसका मकसद भारत की एजुकेशन और साइंस की डेवलपमेंट की बढ़ोतरी में अपना योगदान करना है. भारत की तालीम और साइंस का कंपैरिजन होगा चीन और अमेरिका के साथ. बीट्स में आप देखेंगे टॉक शोज पैनल डिस्कशंस ट्यूटोरियल वीडियोस एंड डॉक्यूमेंट्रीज. Subscribe Beats YouTube channel, like Facebook page and Instagram. Visit its website thebeatsforyou.com.